We've made it to video 4, and so at this point, we are going to turn these things on for the first time. If you're new to the series, we are building out an incredible off-grid system with 6,000 XPs from EG4, along with the wall-mount batteries. Let's jump into it. Now what you're gonna do is make sure that all of your wiring is 100% correct, check and double check the user's manual, and then you're gonna make sure that all of your breakers are in the off position, or open position and off. Same with your AC in and your AC out. Next, we're gonna go ahead and turn on the batteries and turn on the inverters and make sure that our settings are all set up correctly. Since I've already set up these inverters before, I can't show you the process of setting up the dongles and the Wi-Fi settings and stuff like that, but I'll post a card up above where you can check out a great video on that topic. I'm gonna go ahead and turn on my breaker here. This is the battery breaker. Now I'm gonna flip on the battery's internal breaker. And now I'm going to turn on the BMS. BMS just turned on. I've still got the EPS turned off. I'm gonna power on the inverter. Inverter's on. We see the batteries communicating. So it's super important that your load breakers are turned off at this point. Starting with the primary inverter, which is the one communicating with the batteries, navigate to setting 21 to configure the phasing. Press enter again and set the inverter to 1PH, which is split phase parallel. Press enter again and set the inverter to P1. Then repeat this step for all of your inverters. I'm not gonna go through all of the settings here, but one thing I wanna point out is the neutral ground bonding function. This is something you're almost certainly going to be disabling. However, don't take my word for that. Go ahead and do your own research and choose for yourself.
So I've got them all powered up and I've got them into parallel mode. This is the master, and this is the slave and slave. I can see right here 1P-H:P13, 1P-S:P13, and 1P-S:P13. Now I'm gonna go ahead and turn on the EPS.
Quick interruption, if you are planning on buying any of these parts, I encourage you to click on the link in the description or the QR code that I've mentioned. And if you click on this link right here on my webpage, it's gonna take you to this spreadsheet where you can go through and see all the parts and pieces that I used for it with some affiliate links to places like Lowe's and Signature Solar where you get your discount. I appreciate you doing that. And as always, if you want to just help me out, even when you're not shopping for this stuff, start at my links and discounts page. I'm starting to build this out so you can get all of the great discounts and links all in one spot. I appreciate it. Let's get back to the video.
And turn on the EPS. All right. We've got green lights. Shows that they're all happy. It says normal, normal, normal. Now, a super important process is to go through and check your voltages across each of these because we want to make sure that we are not, that they're all in phase, basically. We're gonna check load. We're gonna check the L1 to ground. Actually, it has to go up here. L1 to ground, 120 volts. Then we're gonna go L2 to ground, 120 volts. Check across the two of them, we've got 240 volts. All right, we're gonna check over here on this one, do the same thing. Ground to L1, 120, ground to L2. Looks like we've got 121, a little higher. Across the two terminals, 241. Now this is the important part. We're gonna go ahead and check L1 to L1. And it's 0.7. All right, L2 to L1, and we've got 240. Okay, so these guys are synced up and in phase, at least these two. Let's check these. Okay, we've got L1 to L1, 1 volt, L2 to L1, 240, L2 to L2, 1 volt, and L1 to L2, 240, just shy of it. And we're gonna check to neutral, 120, L2 to neutral, 20. Or to ground, rather. Now, if it was out of phase, it would look a little different. We'd see something like this. We're gonna go L1 to L1. 70, 60, 50, 40, 200. It's bouncing all over the place. It's crazy. So we're not seeing that consistent number of 120 or 120, 240, or zero. It's bouncing all over the place. So we know that these are all communicating through the parallel and they're all working the way that they should. So at the moment, the power is still not going anywhere, and that's good. So the next thing that I'm gonna do is go ahead and turn on the AC in. For this, I'm gonna go ahead and go over to my L1, or to my inverter one. I'm gonna turn this on and turn on inverter 2, inverter 3. Now, they're still not receiving, or they're not getting power into the units, but they should have power right here. I'm getting 250 volts, but nothing here. So what we're gonna do, making sure we're working on the grid, is flip on the grid side. And it's showing 125 volts. So we'll go ahead and flip this one. And we'll flip this one. 60 Hertz, whoop, clicked on. Kind of scared me. Now we're seeing the grid and the grid's communicating. And because it is 11, almost 11:15 at night, these are gonna start charging the batteries because that's what I've got it set to do. Tomorrow, what we're gonna do is flip on the AC out. But before we do that, we're gonna disconnect the inverter bypass up here. And we'll go dark for about 5-10 minutes, make sure that the refrigerant and everything equalizes, whatever is supposed to happen. And then we will switch back over to this system. The last thing I'm gonna do before flipping all of this over is test to make sure that I do have the correct voltages over here on this side, on AC volts. And what I'm gonna do is check from L1 to neutral. I'm not getting anything. Why am I not getting anything? It's because I don't have them flipped on the grid over here, or the load over here. So I'm gonna go to load and turn on load. Turn on load. Turn on load. Now I'll get my 120 volts, 120, 120, 120, 119.5, 119.8. There's a little bit of voltage drop on L3 and around the inverter 3. I'm not sure exactly why, but it's only half a volt. So then I'm checking here, I've got 240 across those two, 240 across those, 240 there, and it's gonna be the same. I'm testing L1 to L2, L1 to L2 over here, and to L2 over here. Now if I test L1 to L1, or L2 to L2, I should be getting 0 volts, which I'm getting 1 volt. Less than a volt. So now what I'm gonna do is go ahead and flip off my disconnect here, and I can yank that transfer switch over there. I can just turn off this 100 amp breaker or turn off this 100 amp breaker. So that's basically what I'm gonna do right now. Let's go ahead and just flip it off. It's gonna go dark. I'm gonna turn this one off as well. And I'm gonna turn that to the off position. Now I'm gonna wait about 5 minutes and then I'm gonna switch things back over. They say you're supposed to give a little bit of time so that your pumps, like your air conditioners or your refrigerators and stuff like that, can equalize with the different voltage phases. I don't understand how all that works, but we're gonna go ahead and wait a minute. All right, it's been about 5 minutes. So now what we're gonna do is switch on. I'm gonna go inverter 1, 2, and then 3. And now we're running off these batteries. This transformation is incredible, and I've gotta say, I love how EG4 just keeps bringing new ways to build the same thing, and it just gets better and better and better. In 2025, I think the 6000 XP is still an incredible buy, and it's still one of the most popular off-grid systems on the market. And you can see why, because it's so modular, it allows for an incredible amount of power. If you're interested in seeing how much power it can actually put out, I've got a video where just this single inverter ran a massive well pump. Check that out at the end of this. And it is just a fantastic system. So with all the new products they have coming out with the FlexBoss 21, the FlexBoss 18, the GridBoss, the 12000 XP, all of the other inverters and products, they are really fantastic products. As you can see, this is an incredibly modular system. You can build it any way, shape, or form that you would like. I still think that in 2025, the 6000 XPs are an incredible buy for off-grid or grid-connected as we are. They're just super reliable. They are modular. They're affordable. They just work and it's awesome. I really enjoy this product. They've got some really great products, EG4 that is, that are coming out. I've got a video coming up on the 12000 XP that we're gonna be installing, so stay tuned to all of that. I'm gonna put out a shameless plug here. If you are gonna buy anything for your solar setup, whether it's a new inverter or batteries or just a simple conduit box or a couple wires, please use my affiliate link down in the description and with this QR code if you're watching on the TV. It really helps out this channel and helps support my family, so I appreciate when you do that. Thanks a lot. Oh yeah, one more thing. I'm Eric, encouraging you to live faithfully and prepare thoroughly for good times or bad. Until proper, but just kind of wiggle them off a little bit. So this is gonna be somewhat, shorting them out is definitely not a good idea. Now, torque, or it has the most amount of, okay. Now it's basically just repeat over here and do the same thing, and then do it one more time. So now it's just repeat. See you on this next one. Stop recording. Stop recording.